A few weeks ago, on our show, we discussed how developers can work towards making women feel more safe in gated communities. This week, we take the debate forward. The security of your house, your property and your belongings. Who's really responsible for this security? The developer who sold you the house with claims of providing you a secure environment, the police of the area, or simply just you?
Venkat Gopalakrishnan is once bitten, twice shy. And that is obvious from these three locking systems for this iron door in his home in Omex Heights in Omex City, Sonipat. His house was burgled in October last year, and since then not only has he reinforced the door and windows, but is busy chasing police, developer and security management company Shanvi Estate Management Services Private Limited.
We had sold a dream actually, at that point of time as looked to us, So we were informed, there is adequate security arrangement to safeguard the lives and the properties of the residents who are going to stay here. And when real something happens like this, then we realize that, it's not a dream what we have bought. We have bought a horror dream actually, So we are horrified.
Our house was robbed. With the grill door broke, main grill door was broken in. The main door was ripped off. Okay, and we lost almost close to 50 lakhs worth of stuffs, which were in the family for 4-5 generations.
Gated communities are sought after because of the promise they hold of a secure living. This shocking theft and several other incidents have raised concerns of security amongst the other residents of Omex City as well. They claim that the kind of security arrangements that were promised by the developer to them have not been delivered despite the charges levied.
कुछ लोग ड्रंकर थे, हैवी ड्रंकर, उन्होंने ड्रिंक की हुई थी, गालियां बकते हुए निकल रहे थे अंदर से. तो मैंने सिक्योरिटी गार्ड से पूछा, यार ठीक अच्छी बात है, मुझे तो तुमने चेक किया, लेकिन कम से कम इनको तो चेक करना चाहिए ना कौन है. बोले सर नहीं, इनको नहीं कर सकते, ये तो आसपास के गांव वाले हैं, बदमाश टाइप के लोग हैं, तो ये तो हमें मार पीट के चले जाएंगे, पीछे भी इन्होंने हमें मारा, तो हम इनको नहीं रोक सकते.
जो भी यहाँ पर दो लिफ्ट आप देखेंगे तो दोनों लिफ्ट पर नीचे आप कैमरेज लगवाएंगे तो वो भी कुछ नहीं हुआ, जिसका 25th नवंबर डेडलाइन थी सभी कामों के लिए. फिर कहा था कि जो वॉल्स हैं, कोई भी हाथ रखेगा कून किया जाएगा, तो उसके लिए भी उन्होंने कहा था कि हम फेंसिंग 2.5 फुट है और इंक्रीज करा देंगे, कुछ नहीं हुआ.
When contacted by NDTV, the developer, Omex, in a written reply has said, and I quote, Shanvi Estate Management Services is employed to provide the residents the best of services at Omex Heights in Omex City, Sonipat. We have strictly instructed them to enhance and maintain a foolproof security system in the township to avoid such incidents, unquote. Curiously though, Shanvi Estate Management Service engaged by Omex has shrugged off its responsibility, saying that they are only responsible for the security of the common areas and not individual flats, and the developer is firm on his stand that after giving possession and handing over the management to the agency, they have no role to play. This despite the fact that construction work by Omex is still going on in Omex City. Residents insist they have been demanding a change of the security and facility management company, but have had no luck so far.
Safety and security are top of the mind criteria for most people who are buying property to live in. And unfulfilled promises can lead to dissatisfaction and disappointment amongst the buyers. That is why it is very important to make sure that your builder-buyer agreement has all the clauses and there are no vague promises, so that later the builder cannot escape his responsibility. From Sonipat with camera person Fahad, this is Anjali Istwal for NDTV.
It is actually an interesting question that we need to tackle. Who's responsible? Because, if you're buying into a gated community with all the amenities, you assume and you're also promised that you will have a secure environment. So, can the developer just wash off his hands? Munish Upadhyay, partner SNG and Partners, advocates and solicitors. And we also have with us Tushankar Saroha, VP Unnati Fortune Group. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining in. I'm going to get the developer's point of view first. What happened in this kind of a story? We don't want to take sides. Clearly, Omex has given the management contract to another company, which now says that we are only responsible for common areas. For God's sake, if the thieves have gotten, they couldn't have flown and landed by a helipad, isn't it? They would have gone through a common area. If there was enough security, if there were enough CCTV cameras, we at least one could have traced back on how did the theft, how did a break-in happen?
Yeah, see, real estate developers create value in a project in terms of design and functionality, of course, security. Three things here.
So saying security is not their problem?
It is in design itself. It's in design and functionality itself. So three things here. One, real estate developer must ensure a credible agency in place to work in consultation with RWA. Second, all the security procedures, internal controls, processes are working. He should ensure that they are in place.
So it is
working.
The developer's responsibility. He can't initially, just wash his hands off.
Initially, yes.
Okay,
initially,
but here yes. there are places where we saw in the images where it's written CCTV. That means there was a CCTV meant to be fixed there. There was a boundary wall which was supposed to be raised there, but it hasn't happened.
See, I haven't seen the story in its totality, so I'm not be commenting on this particular story.
Sure.
But as a group ourselves, I can put it across that three things must be ensured before we hand over the
project
to the end users.
Okay.
As I said, that we create value to the customers in terms of functionality, security, and easy maintenance of the project. All the security procedures, processes, internal controls are in place, must be in place. Builder must ensure a redressal forum in case he gets some complaint from RWA from the end users.
Okay.
And he must ensure that if things are not going as per the wishes of the end users, he, with consultation with RWA, change the security arrangements, change the maintenance contract or agency. And third, Suo Moto doing some kind of auditing procedures once in a year or twice in a year to make sure that the agency is working as per the contractual agreement.
Absolutely. So it is, you know, it's the developer's credibility also, Manish, at stake, isn't it? He's just washing his hands off. Now, the residents have just kind of hounded us to cover this story. They're saying, but you're doing a daily real estate show. You're recommending projects of certain developers. But look how we are getting treated. We have bought into that reputation and now we don't have security.
See, it is to be seen if the security and the maintenance agency is appointed by the builder, then the buck stops at the builder's door. The vicarious liability for the security and maintenance of the building lies on the builder. It cannot be said that the builder has left the residents to fend for themselves, because a portion of that amount which is paid by the residents to the maintenance and security agency is going to the builder also. But it is imperative for the residents in these kind of arrangements to see the agreement. What does the agreement says, which is there between them and the maintenance agency? Does the agreement provides for those clauses, those averments, wherein they have said and categorically taken the responsibility of providing damages and compensation for any kind of thefts? Or does it cover only the common areas? Because in case of any kind of this eventuality, this agreement can be questioned in the court of law. And if the builder has appointed such maintenance and security agency, builder can be squarely made a party to such kind of a complaint in case the any resident does not get...
So Manish, I'm sure that nobody, when they're buying a new house in a gated community, actually sit down and say, even contemplate that my house is going to be, there's going to be a theft, and then who's going to be responsible for that theft. If they say that you're going to be provided a secure environment and there are going to be enough security procedures, CCTV cameras, etc., in common areas, and access to houses is only through common areas, one would assume, isn't it, that this would be a secure place or a gated community for us to live in.
Absolutely. Quite agree with that.
So are we all in agreement that the developer here cannot wash his hands of this particular problem? What
yes.
do you think, Tushankar?
As I said earlier, that a developer is...
Yes or no? Can he wash his hands off by saying that I have given it to the agency and I'm really sorry, now it's not my job?
See, it all depends on the contractual agreement between builder and agency in consultation with RWA. So things should be settled in the context of that agreement, in the arrangement,
okay.
And the common practices across the board.
What do you think? I mean, Manish, is there a hidden agenda here? I'm surprised to know that I wasn't even aware of the fact that if the RWA is paying for the security to the maintenance or facility management company, which is supposed to give security, a portion of it is shared by the developer. Is that correct?
Yes.
In all cases?
Almost
is that true,
Tushankar?
I'm not pretty sure about it. It must be into the maintenance charges which RWA is charging to its own customers and users.
No, so where does the money go? It goes to the facility management company. Does it also go to the developer, a part of it?
As far as I know, it should straightway go to the security agency. We have housekeeping budget charges. We have
Manish,
security.
We
have horticulture.
What makes you believe? I mean, is there enough example and enough proof to say that developers share revenues?
You have to really see the kind of maintenance charges which are being paid by the residents to the maintenance agency for the developers, mostly for the new buildings which are coming up. I have no qualms in saying it is a money making machine for the builders. They appoint their own maintenance agencies, and definitely a portion of all the maintenance charge is going to the developer. So the law is quite clear. Whoever is sharing the booty has to share the responsibility also.
Okay, fair enough. I think we're going to conclude here. We hope that the developer here involved is looking into the matter, or at least after this we'll look into the matter, because it is a developer whose projects we recommend on this show. So, you know, it really hurts us when you have audiences coming and questioning us and saying, why would you recommend shows of developers who are not owning up to their responsibility and have promised us a secure living but are not providing for that? On that note, gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us on this discussion. We'll keep bringing you citizen concerns. So that's also a forum for you to write into us with your feedback and your views. And of course, we have a Facebook page. We also have a Twitter. So please do let us know what your views are.